Hello students, good morning. Students, today is 7th January 2021. Your chapter 9 internal trade was going on. In the last class, I have taught to you chain stores that was relates on the fixed shop, large retailers. So till now, I have taught to you two types of the fixed shop, large retailers. First was relates from the departmental store and second was relates from the chain stores or multiple shops. Today, I want to continue it from the third part, that is relates on the mail order houses. Okay, so next write the heading mail order houses. Okay, so first listen about it. What is the mail order houses? Mail order houses represents that form of retailing in which business transactions are conducting through postal communication without any personal contact with the buyers. As you know about the name, name has been given mail order. Mail means that is totally based on the postage. It means all the orders, all types of the transactions that has been done in that type of the business totally dependent on the postage. Yani jitne bhi transactions honge hum order denge, then after that that type of the order has been delivered through the help of the VPP, through the help of the post office or through the help of the courier. So at that time that type of the facilities is based on the through the mail. So at that time there is no touch, there is no personal or direct face to face relation between the seller and purchaser. Okay, so here we will write about it. Mail order houses represents mail order houses represent, it means that type of the order is represent that form of retailing in which that form of retailing, this is totally based on the retail business. So that form of retailing in which business transactions, retailing in which business transactions are conducted, transactions are conducted, are conducted through postal communication, comma, without any personal contact with the buyers. Okay, it means as per this definition you can also tell about that, you can also see that type of the transactions is based on the totally postal communication. It is totally dependent on the postal communications. Okay, so what are the procedures for mail order houses? So here we will explain about it. Procedure for mail order houses. Mail order houses. What are the procedures? It means how can you give the order? How can the buyers give the order? So firstly, it will be relates on the preparation of the mailing list. Okay. First point is, what is the procedure? So first point is based on the preparation of mailing list. Preparation of the mailing list. First, listen about it. A list of potential consumers is prepared through different sources like telephone directories, list of members of clubs or trade associations. It means that type of the order is based on the collection of, firstly we will collect the data of the different types of the consumers of the different types of the locations. So after that, that type of the preparation has been done and then we will follow the call, you want to purchase that type of the items or not. So this is the criteria. We will prepare the list for the order, and that type of list you can prepare with the help of the telephone directories. Okay, that type of the directives is available in the BSNL office also, that will be provided by the companies, communication companies, the telecommunication companies. So on the basis of that type of thing, first we will prepare a list. First we will prepare the mailing list. Second, approach to customers. Approach to customers. Customers. Listen, the sellers approach the potential customers through advertisements in newspapers or magazines, circulars, catalogs, samples and bills. Advertisements carry all the relevant information about the product. It means at that time, price kya hai, features kya hai, delivery terms kya hai. So each and every type of the thing is totally based on the approach to the customers. It means first we will prepare the list, then second thing will be relates on the approach to customers. हमारा procedure और क्या हो सकता है, हम customer को approach कर सकते हैं. Okay, the good method approach means होता है, we will publish, we will motivate, we will we want to increase, we want to promote our goods to purchase the consumers from the producers, from the sellers. So we will approach that type of thing on the basis of the giving advertisement in newspaper, giving advertisement in telephone or different types of the circulars, catalogs. So on the basis of that everything, we will approach to the customers. So that is the second procedure. Third is receiving of order. Receiving of orders. After approaching, if any customer want to purchase the item, so customers send their orders by post. Order received are entered in the orders received book. It means on the basis of the different promotions method, if customer want to purchase that type of item, so we can receive the orders. Okay, after receiving that orders, we can also record it, then after that we will dispatch it. So third procedure of mail order is based on the receiving of orders. Okay, so there are the three procedures I have told to you. Now fourth procedure is dispatch of goods. Dispatch of goods. It means when the orders has been received from the consumers through the mail, through the posting, post communication, postage. So after that, when the orders has been received by the seller, then as per the order, the orders has been, the goods has been dispatched to the related consumers, related customers. So that is the fourth procedure. Now fifth procedure is payment of goods. Payments of goods. The payment has three ways. First, customer may be asked to make full payment in advance. You know about that. For example, I want to take one example related from the purchasing. So there are the different ways. Full payment has been paid in the advance. Okay, second thing is goods may be sent by VPP, value payable post, in which goods are sent through post and are delivered to the customer only when the full payment is made. It means when the postman, when the delivery boy has visited in your address, then after visiting, then when you will pay the amount to that type of the postman, to that delivery boy, then after that, that goods has been delivered, dispatched to you. That type of the goods has been delivered to you. That is the second method. Third thing is based on the goods may be sent through a bank, which is instructed to deliver the goods only when the customer makes the full payment. गुड्स क्या होता है, हमारा बैंक के थ्रू भेजा जाता है. देन आफ्टर दैट, इफ द पेमेंट हैज बीन मेड कंप्लीटली, फुल पेमेंट हैज बीन डन, देन द गुड्स हैज बीन डिलीवर्ड टू दैट स्पेसिफिक कंज्यूमर्स. ओके, सो दीज आर द प्रोसीजर्स फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ द मेल ऑर्डर हाउसेज, सो वी कैन परचेज इट इन अ प्रॉपर वे. सो एट लास्ट वी कैन से देयर इज नो रिस्क ऑफ बैड डेट्स. So on the basis of that type of thing, the goods has been dispatched, the goods has been delivered on the cash basis. So it must be noted that this business can be successfully carried out when education is widespread, as only the literate people can reach through advertisements and order other forms of written communications. It means that type of the business is success where the literate consumers are available. For example, I want to take one example related on this. If you want to purchase any goods, थ्रू द हेल्प ऑफ द ऑनलाइन प्रोसीजर्स. ओके, आपको गुड्स किसके थ्रू परचेज करें, ऑनलाइन ट्रांजेक्शन थ्रू, दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन द अमेजोन, फ्लिपकार्ट और सो एनी डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द साइट्स आर अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. ओके, सो एट दैट टाइम इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू परचेज एनी गुड्स फ्रॉम थ्रू द हेल्प ऑफ द ऑनलाइन प्रोसेस, सो इट इज नेसेसरी टू नो अबाउट द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशन ऑफ दैट टाइप ऑफ द स्पेसिफिक साइट. ओके, आफ्टर दैट यू कैन रीड इट. If there is any problem relates on the dispatching, relates on the delivery of the goods, or after dispatching, if you see there is any type of the problem in that type of the packet, in that type of the packed material, so you can also complain it in the written form. Okay, so it is possible mail order thing, mail order houses is also possible on the basis of that type of the literate society. If the society has been literate, then that type of the procedure is successful, otherwise no. So for that type of the transactions, for that type of the business, mail order houses is beneficial. Mail order houses will be successful when the society will be literate. If the society will be illiterate, so there will be no benefits to that type of the such type of the business. So mail order houses is success in the basis, on the basis of the literate society. Okay, so suitability, if you want to write it, so you can write about it, suitability of goods for mail order business. Now next point is suitability of goods for mail order houses. Mail order houses. Okay, so here point number one, goods should not be perishable or bulky as they cannot be easily handled. Okay, suitable kis tarah ke goods ke liye hota hai? Goods should not be perishable ज्यादा वजन का नहीं होना चाहिए, ज्यादा भारी नहीं होना चाहिए, और बल्कि as they cannot be easily handled. It means at that time, which type of the goods is suitable for mail order houses? जो क्या भारी नहीं होगा, suitable होगा. It means it can be moved from one place to another place in a easy way. So that type of the goods is suitable for the mail order business. Second thing is based on the mail order business. Houses की जगह आप यहाँ business लिख सकते हैं. Okay, that is because I want to tell here about the business here. Okay. So, mail order houses या mail order business वही success है जहां पर वो goods क्या बल्कि ना हो, ज्यादा भारी ना हो. Second thing is goods should be graded and standardized. Goods should be graded and standardized. Standardized, okay. Standard with ISED लगा देंगे, that is the standardized. It means mail order business is successful on that type of the business where the goods has been graded, a specific grade number, and that type of the goods has to have a specific standard. Okay. Third thing is based on the goods can be easily transported. Goods can be easily transported. Transported at low cost. If the cost price is low, okay, in the transportation, so that type of the goods is suitable for the mail order houses or mail order business. Fourth point is goods should have already demand in the market, or ready to demand in the market. Goods should be goods should have, it is correct word here, goods should have ready demand in the market. If that the demand of such type of the goods is ready, so at that time the goods has been easily sold out. Okay, in the market, because on the basis of that type of thing, order can be easily received, by the customers to sellers. So at that time it is easy to sold out in the market. Now fifth and last point, goods should be available. Goods should be available. Goods should be available in large quantity. In large quantity. In large quantity throughout the year. Throughout the year. Okay. So these are the points. Large quantity में हमारा goods क्या पूरे year में available होना चाहिए. So these are the points. On the basis of that type of thing, we can also deal such type of the goods. अगर ये सारी qualities उस goods में available हैं, so you can follow the mail order business. You can establish mail order business and it will be run in a proper way. Otherwise, it is not possible to get the success in the mail order houses or mail order business. Clear, students? After this, there are the advantages and limitations of the mail order houses. In the next class, I will explain about the advantages and limitations of the mail order houses. Okay, students?